In this video, we are going to learn about the horizon data that is included in the Prospect app, how it is created, how it can be edited, and how it can be exported for import into other third-party software tools. Accurate information on horizon is important for modeling the far shading losses that occur because of obstruction of solar radiation from features such as hills and mountains. There are two ways how to acquire horizon data for a site. The first and the most accurate approach would be to go on site and measure the horizon using a camera or specific equipment designed for measuring the horizon. But this option is not always feasible, particularly in the pre-feasibility phase of a project. The other alternative is to use modeled horizon data. At SolarGIS, we have created a horizon database from a digital elevation model at resolution of 90 meters. The basic concept is to look at the height of the surrounding terrain and taking into account that height in different directions from the reference point. To demonstrate the horizon data features in the Prospect app, we will create a project near a location in Cape Town where there are mountains and hills nearby. After saving the project, we go to the project details section, and inside the project details sections, we go to project info. Here we will see a project horizon and sunpart diagram. We can click on modify horizon button to see the detailed view. In this diagram, we can see the sun path for this location across different times of the year. The red line shows us the sun path in the month of December. Note that this location is in the southern hemisphere, therefore the month of December has the highest solar elevation. The month of June has the lowest solar elevation and will thus have the maximum amount of shading. For example, at this site, we see that the solar panels will be shaded up to 9 a.m. in the month of June, whereas they will be shaded only for a few minutes, let's say up to 6 a.m. in the summer month of December. In addition to the default horizon that is included, you can edit the horizon by simply drawing objects on top of the already available horizon profile. You can undo your changes, or you can press the set default button to go back to the default view. You will see that as you make those changes, the values on the right table are changing as well. There are two other useful things you can do here besides editing the horizon. One is to export the horizon as a .hor file. This is particularly useful if you are using SolarGIS hourly data for simulation in a third-party software that does not include horizon by default, for example, in PVsyst, PlantPredict, or Helioscope. Secondly, if you want to export monthly average solar radiation data from the Prospect app to PVsyst software, then it is also important to set the horizon to zero before you export the data. You should particularly be cautious about this when your project is in hilly regions. Otherwise, there is a possibility that you have factored in horizon shading in the solar radiation data, and then you once again factor in the horizon shading losses in the PV simulation software, and as a result, you overestimate the total shading losses. In order to change the horizon to zero, it's fairly easy. Change the first row height to zero, remove all the middle rows, and then the last row again set to zero, and then save all these changes. And once the changes are saved, the calculations are completed with the horizon profile set to zero. And then you can go on to the data section and download a CSV file that can be exported to PVsyst.